औज़ुबिल्लाह मिन शैतानिर रजीम, बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। सो फॉर इन ब्रिज कोर्स इन अबाउट 12 टू 15 वीडियोस वी हैव स्टडीड फ्यू ऑफ द टॉपिक्स इन मैथमेटिक्स फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 7th 8th एंड एज वेल एज फ्यू फ्रॉम 9th स्टैंडर्ड। नाउ फ्रॉम दिस वीडियो लेट अस स्टार्ट the syllabus of standard 10th in mathematics and the first topic is arithmetic progression. Before understanding what arithmetic progression is, let us study about sequence. Now let me write two set of numbers. Another one is 1 2 3 4 5. So the first set of numbers is 1 2 4 5 3, and then second set of number or the next set of numbers is 1 2 3 4 5. Now here you can easily understand that the second set of number is written by following certain definite rule. Such a set of numbers is said to be sequence. Now how will you define sequence? A set of numbers in which the numbers are arranged or written by following certain definite rule is said to be a sequence. For example, 1 2 3 4 5, same example is taken here. Example number 2 2 4 6 8, so on. So these are the two examples of sequences. Now the standard or general form of a sequence is given by a1 a2 a3 a4 a5, A6, so on, and the last term is An. Or in other words, it can also be written as T1, T2, T3, T4, so on, TN, where T stands for term. Now, T1, T2 or A1, A2, A3, T3 are respectively the first term of the sequence, second term of the sequence, and third term of the sequence, whereas the nth term of the sequence is given by either An or Tn. So where A1, A2, A3 and An are the first, second, third and nth terms of the sequence respectively. There are two types of sequences. One is called a finite sequence, in which the number of terms is finite, and another one is an infinite sequence where the number of terms is infinite. Apart from these two types of sequences, there is one more sequence that is called a type of sequence that is called arithmetic progression, or in short it is denoted as or by AP. So what is AP? How will you define AP? An AP is a type of sequence where the difference between two consecutive terms is always constant. Okay, or in other words, an arithmetic progression is a sequence in which the next term can be obtained by adding a certain constant term in its preceding term, and the number what we are adding is called common difference and it is denoted by small d. So this is the definition of an arithmetic progression. An arithmetic progression is a sequence in which the next term is obtained by adding a constant number, a constant number to its preceding term. The constant term or the constant number is called common difference, and as I said, it is denoted by D. So these 2 to 3 are the examples of an arithmetic progression. Example 1 1 2 3 4 5, so on, is an arithmetic progression because D is equal to 2 minus 1, or 3 minus 2, or 4 minus 3, or else 5 minus 4 is always 1. It is constant. Or if you add 1 to 1, you will be getting 2. If you add 1 to 2, you will be getting the next term. If you add 1 to the preceding term, that is 3, you will be going to have the number 4. So in this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on is an example of arithmetic progression. Now the second example is 5, 10, 15, 20, so on. Here also you can find 10 minus 5 or 15 minus 10 or 20 minus 15. Always you will be going to have 5, that is constant term, or it is called constant number. Alright, so this is also one of the examples of arithmetic progression. Now the third example here is 10, 8, 6, 4, so on. So here 8 minus 10, next term minus preceding term. So 8 minus 10 will be minus 2, or 6 minus 8 will also be minus 2, or else 4 minus 6 is also minus 2. So this is also an example of arithmetic progression. Now the fourth example is 3, 3, 3, 3, so on. Here the value of D, or the value of common difference, is 3 minus 3 is 0. So in this particular, what you call, example, we are going to have the next terms by adding 0 to the preceding term. So this is also one of the examples of arithmetic progression. So in this way, if we consider all these 3 or 4 examples, we can have a note, and the note is the common difference can either be positive. In these two cases, the common difference is positive, or it can be negative also, as in example number 3, the common difference is negative, or else it will be 0 also, as in case of example number 4. So in this way, the common difference of arithmetic progression, it can either be positive, or can either be negative, or else it will be 0. So dear students, after understanding the definition of arithmetic progression and few of the examples, let us see what is the standard or general form of an arithmetic progression. So here is the general or standard form of AP: A, comma A plus D, comma A plus 2D, comma A plus 3D, comma A plus 4D, so on, and the last term is denoted by A plus N minus 1 into D. So this is called the standard or general form of an arithmetic progression, where A stands for the first term of arithmetic progression, D stands for the common difference, and as I said, N stands for the nth term of arithmetic progression. So in this way, A, comma A plus D, comma A plus 2D, comma A plus 3D, so on, A plus N minus 1 into D is the standard or general form of arithmetic progression, and this we have to remember. Now let us solve few of the examples and see how we can find, or how we can mention, or how we can write the first term and common difference. So the examples here are: write the first term and common difference. CD stands for common difference of the following arithmetic progressions. The first example here is 2 comma 5 comma 8 comma so on. So looking towards the given example or given arithmetic progression, write A. A stands for first term, and the first term of this arithmetic, particular arithmetic progression, is 2, and common difference D is nothing but 5 minus 2, the next term minus the preceding term, and 5 minus 2 is 3. So in this arithmetic progression, the first term is 2 and that of the common difference is 3. Now coming to example number 2, 5 comma 9 comma 13 comma 17 comma so on. So here the value of A, that is first term, is 5, and value of D is nothing but 9 minus 5. You can also write 13 minus 9, or else you can also write 17 minus 13. So 9 minus 5 will be 4. So in this way, The first term of this particular arithmetic progression is 5u and common difference is 4. Next example, example number 3. Here the first term is 25u. Okay, pahla term 25u hai. And D, you know, 23 minus 25u. Always you have to write second term minus first term. This you have to remember. So 23 minus 25u plus 23 minus 25u is nothing but minus 2. Okay, 25u minus 23 is 2, that is plus 2. 23 minus 25u will be minus 2, negative value. Now coming to example number 4, the value of A here is 3 upon 2. Alright, the value of D, that is common difference, 1 upon 2, then minus 3 upon 2. So this is nothing but the subtraction of two fractions, and this we already learned. Now LCM of 2 and 2 will be 2, and numerator will be 1 minus 3. Okay, now plus 1 minus 3 is nothing but minus 2. Minus 2 upon 2, 2 ones are 2, 1s are 2, so the value will be minus 1. Hence the value of D, or the common difference in this particular arithmetic progression, is minus 1, and that of the first term is 3 upon 2. So example number 5 is 3 comma 1 comma minus 1 comma minus 3 comma so on. This is the given arithmetic progression. So here the value of A, that is first term, is 3, and the value of D is 1 minus 3, and plus 1 minus 3 is nothing but minus 2. So value of A, first term, is 3, and common difference is minus 2. Coming to example number 6, A here, A is equal to minus 5u, then D is equal to minus 1 minus of minus 5u. Okay, minus 1 minus of minus 5u is nothing but minus 1 minus minus plus 5u, and minus 1 plus 5u is plus 4, that is 4 minus 5u minus 1 will be 4. So in this particular arithmetic progression, the first term A is minus 5u, and that of common difference is 4. Coming to one more example, which is in the form of decimal. So A here 0.6, very easy to write. Then D is equal to 1 minus 7 minus 0.6. So you have to subtract 0.6 from 1.7. So if you subtract 0.6 from 1.7, you will be going to have 1.1. So 1.1 is common difference of this particular arithmetic progression whose first term is 0.6. So in this way, these are few of the examples where we find the first term and common difference. Okay, now few of the examples I have written here for you for practice as homework. Write A and D, that is first term and common difference of the following arithmetic progressions: 7, 10, 13, so on. This is first example. 11, 15, 19, 23, so on. Second example. 12, 9, 6, so on. Third one. And 5u comma 5u comma 5u comma so on, the fourth one. So these examples, you just solve them, very easy to write. First term is here 7, and common difference is 10 minus 7, that is 3. So I say ye 3-4 examples aap kar lo. And important point, note, if AK and AK plus 1 are two consecutive terms of arithmetic progression, then the common difference is given by, this is a simple formula, D is equal to AK plus 1 minus AK. AK plus 1 minus AK. So this formula, इसी formula को use करके हमने यहाँ पर D find out किया है. Okay, so this is very simple formula by which we can find the value of common difference, that is D is equal to AK plus 1, that is next term minus preceding term. So dear students, in this way, in this video, We have studied what is the sequence, what are the examples of sequence, what is the standard or general form of sequence, then how we define arithmetic progression, what are the examples of arithmetic progression. Later we have seen the standard or general form of arithmetic progression, that is a comma a plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d, so on, or a plus n minus 1 into d, the last term. If usko aap likho to bhi chalega, if you don't write to bhi chalega. Okay, now after that what we have seen, we have seen few of the examples how to find the first term and the common difference in the given set of few of the arithmetic progressions. So here let us stop this discussion. Later tomorrow inshallah we shall continue the next part. Thank you very much.